All right, next up is Jason Baker making zoning changes. And then it cut off, so. Everybody likes zoning changes.
Yes, thank you for delegating to me the authority to make zoning changes.
It's really not all that fun, so go ahead.
So I'm here to talk about a couple of things tonight. First of all, my name's Jason Baker. I think I'm the third Jason to talk tonight, which is a popular name for me, I guess. I am the technical director, technical editor for a site called orangepolitics.org. I'm going to put this right back there. So orangepolitics.org is a local blog. We've been around for actually close to 13 years now. We're coming up on our 13th anniversary next week. I've been involved for about 11 of those years. We are a hyper-local blog that talks about all things political in Orange County. And when I say political, I don't necessarily just mean candidates hashing it out in battles against one another. I mean actually talking about local policy changes, talking about zoning, talking about neighborhoods, talking about the sorts of decisions that are a part of everyday government life. And so as we've gone through these 13 years, we've had thousands of blog posts, almost 2,000 comments, and one thing we've noticed as time has gone on is the conversation started to shift a little bit to social media. I mean, we're literally older than Facebook and Twitter, but as time has gone on, some of the conversation's gone there, and so we started to ask ourselves, what's the next step for our organization? What's the next step for people who are working on open government, on bringing democracy to a greater set of people in Orange County, Chapel Hill, Carver, all the other municipalities. So I live, as I said, live here in Chapel Hill. One piece of the puzzle that we started to figure out, and as I've been going through something in my own neighborhood recently, which is a rezoning change. So we're doing something called a neighborhood conservation district in my neighborhood, which is a fancy way of saying that we're going to change the zoning to trying to make sure that we're building the things we want to build and not building the things that we want to build. This is the notification I got from the town. It's beautiful. It's so legible. Those pennies that are blocking out my address are totally actual signs. You cannot read this. So the next project that I'm taking on and have been working on through Orange Politics is developing a toolkit or a framework. I'm still working on the right phrase for this, of making some of the data that you need to make better decisions more consumable. So here's a slightly better map of my neighborhood. And I'm so glad that David spoke before I did, because I'm actually using a ton of his data to do this. A lot of the data that's available through the county, through the town, through different sources like the federal government, the USDA, you know, North Carolina Open Data Portal, some other sources like that. And we're trying to say, what are the critical pieces that you need as you're coming together, as a neighborhood, as a group of people who, like-minded or not, all live together in the same place to be able to make a decision. So we started going through and figuring out, like, what are those critical layers and how can we present them in a way that people can start to edit them and start to understand and make sense out of the actual data. So part of this is, the underlying zoning districts, looking at the actual lots. So if you're making zoning decisions, you're deciding things like, what's the smallest lot that can be in my neighborhood? How wide should frontages have to be, and that sort of thing. One of the issues that my neighborhood faces is a lot of water runoff issues. So we're looking at things like elevation, so which way the water is running. How much driveways are taking up in the area, because you know when the water hits the driveway, it runs straight off, it doesn't soak into the ground. Looking at the buildings, the structural characteristics, how wide your building is, how close it can be to the edge of your property, how tall it can be, all those different pieces. Again, with, you know, adding in the different layers, the roads, the parking lots, the different pieces that sort of you need to make, be able to make regulatory decisions about, and you need to understand what you have now if you want to be able to change it. So I'm working on a sort of toolkit of different ways that people can take the data that's available, that's already public, it's already out there, and apply it easily to their needs and their understanding of their neighborhood. So just to give a couple of more quick examples, this is one of my favorite fun, pretty slides. It's an elevation map of Chapel Hill. If you don't spend much time in Chapel Hill, you're literally a hill. Water runs downhill. And so as you're making a lot of zoning changes that impact things like impervious surface and that sort of thing, understanding which way the water goes is really important. The data is rough. even if I blew this up, it doesn't mean you can understand it. So I'm also trying to come up with better ways of letting people visualize it through things like charts and graphs and that sort of thing. This is just one random example out of our set. It's the percentage of houses falling in sort of a bell curve of impervious surface amounts under one scenario, and flipping through to a different scenario if we made a zoning change, and how that actually impacts people. So thank you so much for providing data. We're actually putting it to use, and that's really exciting to me. So thanks to all the data providers.